Hey, Emmanuel. Hey, we're sorry about last Sunday. We were unable to broadcast the audio portion of our service. And so I just wanted to give you a quick little truncated version of what we talked about last Sunday so you could have a couple key points to take with you as you go into the weekend. And we have everything up and running and we're ready to go this weekend. Our scripture passage for Sunday are 3:16, because we're in a series called 3:16. And our passage was from 2 Timothy 3:16, which is a super important verse from scripture, but one that's probably not known as well as like a John 3:16. And 2 Timothy 3:16, the letter is written by Paul to his apprentice Timothy, who's going to take over Paul's mantle in his ministry when Paul passes away. And Paul wants to inform him in this third chapter of a key principle that is still so applicable for us today, that all scripture is God-breathed. All scripture comes from the mouth of God. It's generated by God. It comes from God's own heart. It is God-breathed. It's not the opinion of men, as I hear so often, that the Bible is just written by a group of men, and it's just their first century opinion. This is not the opinion of man. This is the actual mouth of God that is speaking to you through the Holy Scripture. And all scripture is God-breathed, and it's good for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and training in righteousness. For teaching, that is for instructing, for discipling, for bringing people into alignment with God's will for them in Jesus Christ, for teaching about who God is, that our God is knowable. He is a revealed God. He does not want to stay nebulous and hidden. He wants to be known by you. He wants to be in relationship with you. Reproof means pointing out where we are erring, where we are going wrong, where it is that we are not living in accord with God's will and God's purposes for our life. Correction, bringing you into alignment, not just pointing out where you're misaligned, but now bringing you into alignment with God. The scripture is there as your guide to bring you into alignment for who Jesus is and for what God's will is for you and for this world, and for training in righteousness. That is for a life lived of following Jesus. The Bible should be your tool for daily righteousness and for following Jesus Christ. It's a daily tool. It's not meant to be just heard on a Sunday, but it's meant to be used on a daily basis. Martin Luther had a great practice, and some of you who have been around Emmanuel for a while have heard me talk about this, but his practice was he would read 15 Psalms a day as part of his scriptural devotion, which means given 150 Psalms that are in the Bible from the book of Psalms, that means he would be through the Psalter, the entire Psalms, in 10 days. And so as a consequence, Luther had God's word residing within him. That's the best part. Yes, it's good to be reading. Yes, it's good to be studying. But to have his word within you, supplying the foundations for your thought patterns, supplying the foundations for the way you think about yourself, the way you look at this world, that you are a child of God in Christ Jesus. He bled for you. He died for you. And to have the scriptural truth not just come through your eyes and through your ears, but come out of your heart as a foundation for your whole spiritual life. That's how the word of God needs to function. It needs to live inside of you. And it's good to show you where you're wrong. It's good for teaching. It's good to bring you into alignment. And it's good for that day-to-day Christian walk, training in righteousness. And heaven knows during our times, as troubling as they are and as difficult as they can be and divisive as they could be, how much do we need that training in righteousness? That training to look at the world from a God's point of view rather than from a man's point of view. From God's point of view and how God sees things through the cross of Jesus Christ and his glorious resurrection from the dead, that the end is a victory, that the verdict is in, the scoreboard is final. The game is over. When Jesus Christ said it is finished, the victory is certain, and we need to be trained on how to live our lives that way with a hope-filled posture to know that the victory is already won in Jesus. So we take God's word as authoritative. It's from his mouth. We don't put ourselves above it. We are not ones who are able to stand above God's word and pick and choose like some sort of theological cafeteria what we like and what we don't like. God's word is from the mouth of God. And so as Christians, especially as Lutheran Christians, we champion the phrase, this is Latin, called sola scriptura, the Bible alone. The Bible alone is our sole norm, that is our rule, our norm, in matters of faith and life. That doesn't mean we don't live by other codes or creeds. You know, being in the military, there's lots of other creeds and codes that you live by, but this is the norm Scripture is the norm that norms all the other norms. Scripture is the authority above all other authorities. That is, we as Christians, we will be faithful to the Word of God before we will ever be faithful to the Word of man. If the Word of man leads us to contradict the Word of God, we suffer the consequences and we go with the Word of God. All Scripture is God-breathed. It is the very mouth of God speaking His words. So live in it, study it, have it come through you. Have it available. Let Scripture reprove you. Let Scripture correct you. Let Scripture train you. Furthermore, and use Scripture the way it should be used. Because you notice the Lord Jesus, when He was under temptation in the wilderness by the devil, and the devil was coming at Him in such cunning and deceitful and nasty ways. Remember what the Lord Jesus did. He said, His response was, well, I don't think you're right. And no, God doesn't want me to live that way. Jesus' response to Satan was, it is written. It is written. It is written. He says it three times. And notice the devil even says back to him on the third temptation, you know what? It is written. And the devil quotes Psalm 91. So don't be fooled when an evil mouth can quote Scripture, because the devil knows the Bible word for word. He just does not submit to it as the authority in his life. And so Jesus takes that authority. Paul in Ephesians 6 calls the word of God the sword of the Spirit. He takes that sword and he stabs Satan with it. And he says, it is written. It is written. It is written. And the word of God does not change. We know Jesus, God's will for us, and Jesus Christ never changes, because the Scripture tells us that. And He is the same yesterday and today and forever. So we say, praise God for His word. Scripture alone is our authority. Hallelujah. We'll see you Sunday for another 316. This time we're going Old Testament. So make sure you please join us. This is going to be so much fun. God bless you, Emmanuel. We'll see you Sunday.